And ain't it good to be in Grandma's kitchen?
Grandma's kitchen.
Hello, everybody. Mary Janet here from Tunes and Wooden Spoons. And doesn't it sound calm in here today? That's our granddaughter, Anna, just playing around on the piano for a little bit. So, I thought we were going to have a lot more home today, but Kelly and Krista had to leave and go back because little Rosie wasn't feeling so well. So, I think by the end of the day, we should have a few here. How is everybody? I hope you had as good a week as I had. I am just overwhelmed with yesterday's wonderful launch. It was more than I could have ever hoped for. There had to be more than 300 people that came and lined up to buy a book or get the assigned copy, and I got to meet so many of you that I had never met before. So thank you once again for buying the book and for coming to see me. It was wonderful. And so here we are today, and we're going to be making supper. I'm not so much teaching today because everything is kind of different from the recipe in the book in so much as that I am, you know, making, I'm probably times and a halving my meatball recipe, if you have the recipe book. I didn't post the recipe before the show, but I will post it a little later if there's anybody interested in making my meatballs and the rice casserole. But anybody who has the book has the recipe and adapt it for your own crowd and how many you want. And you have the cookbook open at your recipe, whoever that was. And Francis Corston, hello. Francis Corston is an old neighbor of mine from when I was young and living across the road from her with Mama. And Francis was here the other day. I don't see her enough. She lives in Antigonish with her husband John, and they were here for a little visit and picked, they brought cookbooks for me to sign. It was so nice. She was a Vandenhogen from across the road and had purchased my great-grandfather's house and farm, and they were farming there. But anyway, Francis's husband John, he weaves, and he brought me a beautiful dish towel. Francis, I'm sorry, I don't even have it here to show you guys, but I used it and I had put it in the laundry this morning because it was all damp. But thank you very much. Beautiful, beautiful. So many gifts I received yesterday from so many of you wonderful people. So thank you. Nobody has to do that. I'm just saying I want to thank you all, and I will find you personally and thank you very much. So there is a birthday. There's a very special birthday for this one person. And her husband had emailed me and knew that she was a faithful watcher of the show. And so I want to wish Karen Santacona. Karen Santacona, if you're watching today, give that husband a big kiss, because he asked me to wish you a happy birthday on the show, and I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful day. So we're going to get right at this, and I'm going to pull in some of my helpers here to help me prepare this supper. If you can see on the counter, I already made my biscuits. They just came out of the oven, and Brennan's wife, Kelly, rescued them because I was up there trying to fix my hair, and the timer went off, and she got it out of the oven for me. So I'm going to have lots of help today. Brennan is here, Margie is here, Anna is here, and Kelly is here, and we'll see who arrives along the way. We're hoping that Mitchell and the kids can come and join us as well. And where is Mary Sarah? And Mary Sarah is here. That's right. She's quiet as a mouse, and she's somewhere in the house. That rhymed. Okay, so let's get started. I am going to go wash my hands. Who's helping me with the meatballs? You'll help, Kelly? You'll help? Kelly Tomlinson, I call her. Hi, Shirley Beaton. Oh, it was so nice to meet you yesterday and see you in person. So,
hello, everybody.
You guys can introduce yourselves, and I'll wash my hands first.
Hi.
Hi, Kelly.
Okay, so the first thing we're going to do, we're going to make the meatballs. And, oh, here's Brennan. Come on over, Bren.
Hi, everybody. What's up?
I take no responsibility for what my children may say on camera, especially that fella. So, okay. Pardon me? Good plan. And there's lots of aprons in the closet there. Maybe not necessarily all tunes and wooden spoons, but there's... Oh, look for you. Look at you. They're all set. Okay. Oh, pick that gem up. You washed your hands.
Yeah,
you can't
do
that.
Yet.
We have to introduce you to Bria.
Say hello, Bria.
Bria, you going to say hi? Huh?
She's going to be looking for a meatball pretty soon, I think.
Bria is just a... wonderful, nice, wonderful little dog. Okay, so I am going to start mixing the meatballs. And I'm just going to leave it kind of on everybody here. And I'll get the meat out of the fridge.
Am I helping or am I just...
No, yes. You're helping.
You're on onions. You get to do the onions.
Oh,
okay. I'm just going to do this over on the counter.
Since I didn't get the crying gene, I guess that... Yes. I'll make up for it this way.
You got to be pretty backed up, Brennan, you know?
What? Trust me. In years.
I only cried 25 times yesterday, so...
Did you? Really?
Yeah, today I'm off. The deer,
all right.
Deer
booty. Ew, gross. I don't think I've had one of these on yet.
No, I don't think so.
What would you say?
What if the recipe calls for
salt? Oh, I'm a little tall for the camera.
Nobody loves the camera.
How are we doing?
It does seem strange to be talking in the kitchen and knowing everybody's listening.
This is set for 5'5" people and under, I think.
Well, no, I had to put it down so people can see
it's for the bowl. It's all
yes.
For the bowl.
So, Brennan, I'm going to give you a job. Here are some onions.
I've been told already.
Oh, good.
I'm going to cry.
Okay.
Oh, they're shredding? They're not slicing?
Definitely not slicing. I do not like to bite into an onion, but I don't mind them shredded.
Well, yeah. Good.
So you get to do that. I'm giving him 2 onions, about that big. And I'm not following the recipe today for quantity, so you make the quantity that you're for your crowd. So I am doing like about 1.5 times, but basically I'm just guessing. So the recipe calls for 2 pounds of hamburger, 2 eggs. So I have 3 eggs, for example. I'm gonna dump everything in here. And that's what I do. Picked these eggs up this morning from my neighbor. Farm fresh eggs. Brown and white eggs. And then we're going to need some breadcrumbs.
Teresa the hen?
I do not know the name of the hens, but I've gone to visit them once. So these are just plain breadcrumbs, but you can use those ones that come with... I've used the ones that are like herbed ones, and that's fine too.
Am I going to be in the way if I'm right here?
No, yeah. Can't even see you.
That's probably a good thing.
All right, and the onion and some garlic powder.
Put these kids to work too, eh?
Margie, would you get me the measuring spoon? I didn't put it out here. You know what? I'll just do this, which is what I usually do anyway.
Anna's waiting for her Burger King promotion to start cooking, maybe. So
really?
Good training ground.
Garlic powder and some salt. Yeah, look in the closet. Anna, right over there in the closet, hanging up on there, there's about 10 aprons. There's a lots in there. CTV one, there's the other one. Cape Breton apron is in there. Oh, you got a tombs and wooden spoons. I hope it's clean. Okay. And pepper. Lots of pepper. Until I use my hands to mix this all up, okay? Do you guys use your hands when you're mixing too?
She uses plastic bags over her
hands. Oh my God. That would be my daughter-in-law, Kelly.
I can't stand the way it feels.
So how are you gonna make the meatballs?
Get some plastic bags.
She uses plastic bags to mix.
Just.
Yeah.
Okay. Use this shredder.
Mainlanders.
Mainlanders.
My mother is probably mortified.
I'll do my best to keep my fingers out of this.
Okay, hamburger, eggs, breadcrumbs, onion, pepper, garlic powder, and salt. So the only thing I'm missing is the onion.
Oh, sorry. I'm going to try not to swear.
Production down.
Yes. While you guys are sitting on your behinds over there.
We're gonna score you in a bit.
Well, that's a. Don't want that in there.
Okay. Do you have at least one ready?
Well, what I got of one, yeah. You want it in there? Here, yeah. This only takes a second.
Okay. Here you go, Anna. You can put that in the garbage. And put it in the sink here, these two. And I'll get you guys, as I'm using stuff, I'll get you to put it away. The salt and the breadcrumbs and, yeah, I think that's everything. So today we are having the sweet and sour meatballs, which is it's good to feed a crowd. And I'm making rice, my Aunt Flora Mae's rice casserole. And what else? Are we making the sauce for the meatballs, of course.
Oh, my jeepers.
So I don't want any of those big pieces, Brennan.
Oh, I'm trying to shred them.
I can't see.
I'll chop those up because I can't shred them anymore.
No, I don't want them chopped up. I'll just take the shredded stuff.
Just the shredded stuff?
Yep.
Do you want me to do a third onion with this?
No, that's good. Just.
You're too slow.
Yes, it's a hard crowd here.
I'll take that.
Do your fans know this language that Brennan is speaking?
Yeah, Brennan. Brennan is using Gaelic swear words here.
Sorry.
He's fluent in them.
That's all I got.
Okay, just give me the whole, give me the whole thing. And I will deal with that. So here's his two onions.
Making fun of me. I'm trying to help.
Here you go. That can go in the garbage. Now, I'm just going to add in the onion.
Put them in your purse.
I know, it is hard on the eyes. And you know what? Every trick that everybody has ever told me about onions doesn't work. I have not found it to work.
Yeah, little tricks.
I saw one where someone wore a hoodie and then they put like a clear like lid for like a pot like inside the hoodie and like tightened the string. It was like a shield.
The one that works really well if you just tell your brother to do it.
No mascara running today.
Well, I was rushing, so I didn't put any on. So.
Okay, here we go. That can go. Okay, so now we're ready to make meatballs. Are you ready? And Kelly?
Do you have any plastic bags?
Well, Kelly, okay. If you look at the top up there. There are plastic bags. If you're seriously going to
do this. I think you can make an exception.
Today I'll make an exception.
Okay.
So So before we start and before I instruct these kids and grandkids and daughters-in-law, when I make the meatballs, have you ever had a meatball that is really hard and, you know, you try to cut into it and it flies across the plate or something like that? I do not want, I make a meatball about this big and I just do a little bit of that, leave it loose, not tight. If the tighter they are, that's when they cook, they will be harder like that. And so basically just a little bit like that. And it depends on how big you want them. So this is about my size. People can see that. Can you pull that over a little bit?
I got meat on my hands.
Oh, now, I'll go over. Yep. I'll go over.
Okay.
Here we go. What would you say that is? It's probably about an inch and a half wide. And you know, it doesn't really matter. Whatever. Okay, so I'm putting them on a parchment-lined cookie sheet because, and I have my oven set at 350. I wasn't going to do a tutorial. We were just going to make this, but I automatically want to do that. So dig in, everybody, because we've got to do this. So my oven is set at 350. And we're just gonna make the meatballs. Well, they're kind of big because they're just the Ella Grotti and Rita and Bernice are coming.
Gotta feed everybody.
And Bernie G. Bernie G's coming.
Here, you catch them.
Yeah, sure. Oh, here. Oh. Let's put them right here.
Oh, that's fine.
This is like all different shapes and sizes.
They are. I see. There's big ones there.
An all-inclusive batch of meatballs. Yeah.
Okay. So.
You guys are a bunch of meatballs.
How many people are watching this crazy family? How many are watching today, Brennan? Is it 220 or something? I think.
Jeepers, 820 people. Oh my God. Or, no, wait, no, that's my eyes.
Oh, yeah.
Still oniony. It's
no,
blurry.
It's 833.
Yes.
Oh, Lord. You guys.
Well, that one's for 828. Whoever you are, that one's for you. There you go. Put that right in your face, Margie. I can make it look like you're a meatball.
So because we are having, you know, so my brother, for anybody who doesn't know this, my brother, Alec Roderick, lives in Michigan and came home for the launch of the cookbook. He drove home, he and his wife, Rita, and they're going to be here. They stayed with us up until a week ago, and then they went over to Manadu, where she is from, or they have a cottage in Catalone, and then they came over yesterday for the launch, and they're coming here, and they're staying tonight with us.
It's a little crowded up on this pan.
Well, I have another pan. Guess what? So here, I put about that many on the pan, and I would like to count to see how many it makes in the end when we're ready to.
Mary Sarah, that's a good job for you.
Oh yeah, Mary Sarah, where is she?
Mary Sarah.
Turkey. Come here, meatball.
Are you traumatized yet?
I'm really enamored.
Humans are the most
embarrassed that 821 people may know that I roll meatballs with plastic bags on my hand.
And I'll have you know, you all love Cape Breton, I think, or many of you do anyway. And this lovely daughter-in-law of mine, are you the marketing?
No.
Communications director of tourism for the province of Nova Scotia? So she loves Cape Breton and mainland Nova Scotia just as much as we all do. And I have her here slaving and making meatballs and worried about the texture of the meatballs.
Well, I can tell you, I feel really lucky that I have a job that involves promoting Nova Scotia and Cape Breton to the world. And I think I couldn't be more proud to have Mary Janet doing what she's doing to help all of you learn more about the amazing culture and people and communities. And I grew up in the mainland, which is absolutely amazing here in Nova Scotia. But when I met Brennan and met this family, I really didn't know I couldn't believe I was so fortunate and so lucky. So yes, if you have a chance to come and visit us, do come and visit us, because it's a pretty special place.
It sure is, and thank you, and we are just as lucky to have Kelly. That's for sure.
We'll keep her, yep.
How many years have you guys been married now?
Too many.
18.
Did you say 18 because you didn't figure he remembered?
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, Mary Sarah, did you count them?
I just lost my count.
Okay, let's count them.
Count them quickly.
Let's count them. Come on.
Here, she'll count that tray, you count
that tray.
Okay,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 34 there.
How many? 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18,
48 and 34, how many does that make? About 90-something?
48 and 34 would be 82.
Okay, we should be asking Margie. She's the senior high math teacher here.
Yeah, I'm off duty.
Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to put them in the oven for, I don't know, it varies. I have two pans, probably 25 to 30 minutes, and they're just going to get brown. It's better than frying them on top of the stove. They maintain that softness, and you're not getting a fried edge on one side and then not on the other. I just love this recipe, and I got this recipe from a cookbook that's a local cookbook here in Port Hood. It was put out by our church's ladies, the CWL, and the recipe was put in there by a very good friend of mine, Glenda Campbell. And Glenda, if you're out there watching today, she's in her hospital bed in Inverness. And we love you and we miss you here in Port Hood. And we hope that you feel much better soon. So let's put this in here. And maybe we can, after that, while this is in the oven, we're going to put together the sauce, okay? And then we're going to make the rice casserole, and we'll just be ready to have a party. Okay. Somebody else take over the...
Yeah, got you.
Okay, let's see if I can do this. I'm going to have to do it this way. And put the other one on the second shelf. Okay? And leave it out to the edge so that it gets. And I'm going to put it in. I'm going to put it in for 30 minutes. 10, 20, 30. Okay. I'm gonna wash my hands.
Does that start automatically?
Yep, it starts automatically. Yep. Okay. Do you measure cups on? I think I'm good. I might. I'll see as we go along. So the sauce. So the sauce is 2 cups of brown sugar, very sweet. They all left me. I don't need anything. No,
you're not
I don't.
Fair.
That's one. Two. So that's 2 cups. I'm just gonna put just about another half a cup, but not quite. So I'm trying to times and a half it, but I don't want too sweet. Okay, and we need, I think it's a couple of tablespoons of cornstarch. Oh yeah, that's my 2 tablespoon measure. So I'm gonna put 2 in, and I don't know, a little bit more. Maybe another tablespoon. You can put that away, Margie. And I'm actually going to mix that up.
So you're making a batch and a half kind of thing?
Kind of a batch and a half.
Okay,
yeah.
But the recipe is like for a batch.
The recipe is for a batch.
Have you ever made only a batch? Probably not.
I have never made just a batch. I never have. Because it was always for the crew, you know. Okay, so there, you mix that cornstarch in with the brown sugar so that it will be really well incorporated there, because cornstarch has a tendency to be lumpy if it's left by its, on its own. Okay, so let me see. Brennan, watch them comments in case there's any questions.
Okay. Jason Price. I lost it.
Aw, darn it.
We saw Jason Price last night in Glencoe Station. Him and Jimmy Inch. We all went to see them. Great show.
And Jimmy Inch, they were on the show back when I made the herb bread. And I mean, they're two freaking characters, especially Jimmy. Yesterday they came, they were doing a gig here in Glencoe Station. I do need a cup, Margie, cup measure. That's a half cup measure.
Yep.
Actually.
One here.
Yeah, that one. Yeah, I'll use that. I need that one. Use that one with there, over there. So yesterday they came and they had their lovely wives with them, and they were in the lineup. And Jimmy had me sign on his cookbook that the day that he was here, I had to put on it, Jimmy's herb loaf of bread was better than Jason's. So
that was one of my favorite shows when they were on.
They were a treat, yeah.
Oh my God, they could be a comedy duo. They just feed off one another. Okay, what was that? One cup? Yes, one cup. So it's two cups, so I'm going to put three. I should have asked you to get me the big measuring cup, but I guess I'll do it cup by cup. Of course, nothing but the best. Heinz.
Always used to hate when Dad would put Harmony ketchup.
Oh,
oh my gosh.
It's not the same.
And then when it got low, he'd just add water to it.
Swish it around.
Swish it around. You'd do a big puddle of red liquid underneath your french fries. It's fine. It's the same thing. Every last drop.
Do you remember the Kraft dinner? We made the Kraft dinner, but he'd make a box Kraft dinner and then add macaroni to it to make it go further. And then add tomato soup to that.
Yeah. Oh!
I actually like the tomato soup.
You know what?
I like the tomato soup.
I preferred it, actually.
Do ya?
Yeah.
So I'm going to put in here a cup and a half of water.
Probably making people dizzy, sorry.
You're so sorry.
Actually, I have to tell everyone a story. So
do tell me a story. Okay. Here we go.
So I'm not sure if people have picked up on the swaying of the family, but they all do this. And I remember the first time I went to church with them all, we were all in one big long pew, and all of a sudden I felt myself like in this massive like sway. Like, what is this? Is this something that I'm not Catholic? So I was like, is this Catholic? Is this a Catholic? Anyway, it was the first time I experienced it, and it is constant everywhere. I felt us doing it earlier when we were waiting, right? Swaying is a family trait.
It is. And you know what? I'm guilty of that. This morning I was in church and I was doing the thing on the computer, and there were three singers in front of me and they weren't swaying, and I wanted to, and I did. I just did a little bit back and forth. It brings me great comfort. I love it.
The worst is when you go the opposite way, you climb.
That's terrible.
It started the church fight.
Okay, so in here, it asks for 2 cups of brown sugar, 2 tablespoons of cornstarch, 2 cups of ketchup, 1 cup of water, and 1 cup of vinegar, and just 1 teaspoon of soy sauce. But of course, I've increased it by another half a little bit. And should we find soy sauce?
Did you put soy in there? It's over there in the bucket, the pan, glass thing.
Good descriptor.
It's where it always is. And the thing.
And the thing. You sound like your mother, actually. I know people will be making fun of me sometimes because I can't think of the word.
think of your children's names half the time.
I have called them by the dogs' names on occasion.
Regularly.
Yeah. Dogs that have been dead for 20 years, she still pulls those out.
If it starts with that letter.
Morgan. Maggie.
Oh, I love it. Mary Tomo just said, Catholic slayers, it's a thing.
Okay, Kelly, give
me for a choir, the Catholic slayers.
That's a new band name. Oh my God. Family band name.
Okay, I'm taking this to the stove. Brennan, can you take them to the stove?
I don't know if I could lift all 837 of them, but I'll try. Is this charger actually working, Mom? Because it wasn't working earlier this morning. Did you notice that?
I've never noticed.
And I can't see if it...
Oh, just...
Oh, am I supposed to touch that?
Well, I don't know.
Don't touch it.
Oh, you paused something. No, you didn't.
No?
No, swear. I'm just... Swear.
Swear.
Well, we're still in business. We're still good.
Oh my God.
These
poor people. I'll do it.
Yeah, we're doing good. So I'm right now, I'm just whisking the sauce. Oh, Margie, yeah. Would you go get the large roast pan? That's what I cook when I do the meatballs. The large roast pan, it's down there in the closet. The smaller roast pan is on top of it. The old fashioned oval one.
I don't know. I'm a terrible cameraman. Do you want that up so they can see in the pot?
That'd be a good idea.
Does this come up further?
We can just do this.
Well, I can.
Here.
Yeah, do you want me to tilt it so that it's... here?
No, that's good. They can see in the pot. They can see in the pot. Here. Perfect. All perfect.
Right. Good.
Yeah, I'm the only one who sways in this our school music video. Heard old
So basically, I'm just going to bring this to a boil. It's great.
How hot is the oven and how long?
I cook it at 350 and I cook them for an hour because I usually do the rice and the meatballs at the very same time and then they're coming out at the very same time.
But these are only in for 30 minutes.
These are only in for 30 minutes, yeah.
The meatballs cook for 30 minutes.
And then with the sauce for an hour.
Yeah.
That's soft. So cute. So, let's see. Bring to a boil and simmer for 5 minutes. What did I miss?
My phone just lit up because it thinks I'm driving. I move so fast to that cupboard. So scared to mess something up, right?
Oh my God, that's great. I'll probably try putting that light on a little bit and see better. So please, we call. Mayor, who else is on there? They can see. I'll have to come cook with you sometime, Mary Janet. Ryan, yes, you can do that, Ryan. What was that? Beverly Beaton Bowers. What's she saying? Oh, darn it.
They go by so fast.
I know. I only get to see one at a time. I mean, this is a standard dish that so many people around here used to come. And if you go to potlucks, you always got that. But it's kind of phased out in these times and with your generation, I find. Yeah, but it's still good when you have it.
And what's funny is they're probably all very similar recipes, but they're all very different. Like I find you go to a wake or wedding or something, there's a potluck kind of thing, and every meatball as you try is like you're judging one against the other.
Yeah.
There should be like a meatball off.
Meatball off.
A bake off. That'd be fun.
Yours would have been, Mom.
Yeah. I'll defend Glenda's recipe.
Yeah.
I've done others, but this one I always come back to.
I'm telling you.
Yeah. Yeah. Brennan, do you want to just... hold on, maybe we should use the tasting spoon.
What's that?
Kevin. Oh, that's the wrong one.
They're so good they bit it off.
Kevin Fowley from Port Hawkesbury.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, the guy that I had on the... He made a tasting spoon, and it's got a little tasting...
That looks like a hobbit spoon.
Doesn't it?
Probably one of the earliest designs.
See how that tastes.
Oh, how hot is it?
Not very hot yet.
It's coming.
It's coming?
Yeah. It's not hot.
I didn't put as much sugar in as a times and a half. I probably let it...
No harm in the brown sugar.
No harm in the brown sugar. Should have put the other half a cup in?
I just brushed my teeth, so it's not really...
Okay.
It's not really tasting like it should, probably.
Okay, give me a little more brown sugar there.
A little sprinkle of brown sugar there.
With that half cup measure. Girl, stop talking and not help me.
What do you mean?
Sorry.
Quit your gabbing and swaying and get over here.
The brown sugar.
Yes. Okay. I'm driving. You will not receive notifications while driving.
That is pretty fun.
I have a container. You don't need a bag.
Yes.
That's all right. We'll take whatever you can give us.
Hard to find good help these days, Mary Janet.
What?
It's hard to find good help these days.
And they put the brown sugar back in the wrong place anyway.
Aren't you getting choosy with
it? Well, I mean...
Brennan can just do it all then. You like him better anyways.
Here, a little bit more. Okay.
We good?
We're good.
Am I allowed to put it back?
You can put it back, but where are you putting it?
I'll put it in this cupboard.
Yes, on the right-hand side.
I just didn't want my rear end in the game.
That's when they come home for the weekends at times, and they're all so good to help and clean up and whatever, and when for days after they go back, I'm like, where the heck did that go? Where is this?
Pick.
Am I allowed to put the vinegar away?
Do I need the vinegar? I don't need the vinegar. No. Yeah, well, you can put
the meatball sauce. Can I put all the stuff away?
You can put all of that stuff away except for the soy sauce. I need that. I always want to say soya sauce.
Isn't it?
No, it's soy sauce.
No, I think it's soya.
Is
well,
it?
In French. Maybe it's
soya. Oh, that's what it is. Okay.
I've been reading the wrong side of the bottle all these years. I called it soya sauce.
So is soya, okay. I don't know, but anyway, I'll put it over here.
Soy sauce makes more sense than everything else.
It does, doesn't it?
It does, so yeah.
Say this one on camera.
Worcestershire. I always said Worcestershire. But is it pronounced Worcestershire?
I just say, could you pass me the bottle with the brown sauce in it?
Brown sauce.
Because I don't want to say that word.
I always say Worcestershire sauce.
Worcestershire.
Chesterfield sauce.
Oh, it can be said both ways, says Holly.
Okay, good to know.
Which one?
I'm serious.
Worcestershire.
Holly, please clarify. Which sauce can be said both ways?
I think it's soy sauce.
Okay, I think so. We didn't Worcestershire.
They should just combine them. Make Worcestershire sauce.
Okay.
Yeah. Is it supposed to boil?
When it comes to a bubble, then for 5 minutes, we'll let it simmer.
Kelly, I think this was the first meal I ever made for you.
Oh, my God.
Get out.
She came, she came over for the first time to my apartment living with five other crazy fellas in Halifax, and she came over for supper.
Was that on Queen Street?
It was on Queen Street.
Yeah, okay.
And I made mom's biscuits, sweet sour meatballs, and rice. And I think she came
Tell
for supper.
How long it took.
I think we ate at 10 p.m.
I was trying to be very patient. I get really hungry.
I
was
hadn't made them prior to that. It don't take that long.
That should have been a
fun. You guys that all did that because Mitchell's mother and father-in-law were here, and they said... They were saying, when Mitchell came to our place first and he was dating Laura, He made a supper and he made ice cream cake, and he just never has made another meal or dessert since he got Laura.
Yeah. Once you get the girl, then you can stop doing all those things.
Except for Nash, right?
Let's talk about Nash. He's not on here, Mary Janet.
Is he watching?
He's watching today.
Well, I'll just tell you a little bit about Nash.
What? Cool.
He's a little sweetheart, and I've only met him the one time, and he's Anna's...
I'll ask Barbara.
...friend. Boyfriend. And he's cute, and he landed at her door the other day. She's going into grade 11. Anna is going into grade 11.
She's in it now.
She is in grade 11, yeah. Sorry. And he brought her flowers. Keep that fella. That's
keep,
a good
keep
fella.
Keep him away.
Nash said hi.
Barbara was asking which cookbook was Glenda's meatball recipe in.
It was in the St. Peter's CWL cookbook from Port Hood.
It was a St. Peter's book from Port Hood?
St. Peter's
Church.
Parish.
Church. Okay.
You were mixed up.
Yeah, I was.
You can stir that, Brennan. I'll get the book so they can see it.
It takes a while for this to bubble. Would you suggest that you've got to keep this stirring? Will it burn on the bottom if you don't, Ma?
I always want to do that because I don't trust that it wouldn't burn.
Yeah, I figure with all that sugar and sweet stuff in there, it might burn.
Well, there you go. I was looking for my hairbrush.
Barbara said it's a blue-covered cookbook.
Yep. Got it here somewhere.
Looking for a cookbook? Find a hairbrush.
Brennan, I think people like how you're stirring the pot.
Do they?
Brennan stirs the pot often.
Mags is quick on the draw.
Oh, yes, he does. Yeah.
There is Glenda's recipe.
Look, it's written right on there.
The best.
There you go.
The best. And the cover is recipes for young and old. St. Peter CWL, Port Hood. Now, a good friend of mine, Mary Florence Beaton, was the...
She's turning the bubble, Mom, pretty good.
Here. Yeah, okay. I'll set the... When that's down to 6 minutes, we'll turn it off.
Because I know that, well, this is not fudge, but I remember we lived in the old house. You had glassware, like bowls, and they had roses on them, and they had a little bit of a pattern in them. And we decided to make fudge one day. You weren't home. I decided to make fudge one day, and I remember stirring it in the pot, and it was bubbling and boiling. And anyway, thought it was a great idea. I was so proud of myself. Poured it in before those glass bowls, let them sit for a while, and it was about as hard as this pot when it cooled.
Oh, yeah.
And it wasn't coming out, and I ended up smashing the bowls out on the picnic table.
You probably never told me.
No, I didn't. But I still wanted to eat the fudge. So I had to smash the bowls to get a piece of fudge out of them.
Now, did you butter the bowls?
No, jeepers. So how would I know that?
He's pretty good to cook, though.
Oh, Brennan is a good cook, yeah.
Yeah.
He has the time.
He's creative,
if
you can call it.
Creative.
I don't do
that. What has been his greatest creation?
Tortillas, ham, and cheese string. And then
what?
He turns them into like faces, like when we were
kids. Oh, yeah!
That was Brennan's trademark, actually. He always, since the time the kids were little, he always made faces on the plates for every meal. Yeah, so, and he would always take a picture, so I think someday you'll be able to give the kids a picture of every meal that you've ever made.
I know, you would post some of them on Facebook, all these faces before they would have lunch or whatever, or breakfast.
Yes,
famous.
Into a millennial.
Oh my god, and he also, Brennan always also wrote notes for lunches too. But remember the day, what did you do to Mary Sarah? You gave her like moldy bread or something?
No, you gave me moldy naan bread.
Oh yeah, I gave Anna moldy naan bread? I will never forget, she got to school. How did it work? You wrote a little note the next day that I found, and I couldn't stop laughing because it was
so. I texted him, I'm like, you gave me moldy naan bread in my lunch today.
You gave me moldy naan bread in my lunch today, and the next day Brennan wrote a note something like, I hope you have a good day, enjoy your lunch, honey. But it was funnier than that. this story is a
great story, Kelly. Man, that was a great one.
That was my last appearance.
Yeah.
I don't know either.
Yeah, I'm sure there was something humorous in there somewhere.
I can just imagine the notes that this fellow would write you.
Oh my gosh, I still have a few. They're interesting. I don't know if they'd be like cooking show.
What do you think?
I think it's just another minute or so to go. So how's everybody doing? We're here. We're being silly. This has just got about a minute to go, so it'll be ready in about 5 or 6 minutes. The meatballs should be ready, and we'll put it all together. And I should get these guys. No, I'll wait. We'll do the rice together because it's quick and easy. And the rice recipe was my Aunt Flora Mae's. And one of the things that you're supposed to have in it is a can of sliced mushrooms. And so on Friday night, the publishers, there were seven of them in the publishing team, you know, partners and wives and mothers and all of that. But anyway, they were coming for supper and as I said, Friday night, the night before the launch. And I was making the creamy baked chicken dish and some of the little potatoes and had carrots and yeah, salad. And for some reason I made a rice casserole too. It wasn't the plan. The plan for that can of mushrooms was for today. And I went ahead and I made it on Friday night. So guess what? I went to get all the ingredients ready. I don't have the can of sliced mushrooms. And I don't even have any fresh mushrooms, which I could have had, to go in with the rice. So anyway, while there's 6 minutes left, we're going to put together the rice. It's quick and easy. And then we can put everything in the oven for 1 hour, and that will be ready. So you can take that over to the table, Brennan. And we can do this. Margie, you want to cut that up?
Sure. Cutting board.
There you go.
There's a dish there somewhere. Okay. There you go.
Be quick.
You want it on the table? Like
the whole thing? Want the whole thing cut?
Yeah, might as well, yeah. Because I don't like leftover in there any more than a couple of days. So we've got 2 cups of Uncle Ben's long grain rice. It's the converted stuff that I use. And it's good to spray your pan with some cooking spray.
Or WD-30.
You talking about Queen Street there, Mom, when you were making dinner for Kelly? Every time I think Queen Street, I think of you. Tell the story of, remember you'd shut the light off in your room and you'd have to walk by the picture of Mab and Grandma and Pornhub Grandma. And because Mab and Grandma was such a trickster, you always thought it, from the photo she was going to go to scare you. Every time I think of Queen Street or see that photo, that's what I think of. And I wait for her to do it to me too. It looks stuck with me.
I don't remember that.
Oh my god,
That's so funny.
So it's 4 cups of water.
Okay, Mary Jane, while you're getting water, there's a lady named Flora Martin on your comments today. Her name is Flora Mae.
Flora Mae. Yeah. We were saying the other day, Flora Mae, she had the best laugh.
Oh my God, yes.
Just right from her toes.
Yeah. Pretty awesome lady.
Actually, when John Corston was here the other day and gave me that woven dish towel, Flora Mae used to have a loom and she used to make, you know, place mats and everything else, and so it reminded me of her. And now today we're making her rice casserole, so she's all around us. Okay, to this I added 4 cups of water, 1/4 cup of soy sauce.
Of what sauce?
Soy sauce. I know, I always say soya sauce.
So do I.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I'm like curious now.
Which is right? Margie's doing up the green pepper. A package of Lipton or whatever, onion soup mix. Brennan, will you go to the closet over there and get that big roll of foil wrap?
So you can go faster than me. Mom, are these chunks?
Are they that's fine. Throw them in. Okay. 1/4 cup of oil. It should be on the second shelf at the back. 1/4 cup of oil. I know. I think you gave me that when you brought that great big thing of groceries from Costco for the show.
Well, there you go.
Brennan.
You ready for this or not?
So I'm just going to stir that. And at this point, we should have put the mushrooms in, but all we have today, it also asks for celery, but I never put celery in. Can't stand celery. So I only make it to please myself.
I'm surprised you like green peppers, actually.
I don't mind it because they kind of shrink down. They're not so bad. So there's a minute left.
And 4 celery.
So I just put the foil wrap over it tightly, and it doesn't come off until it's cooked. So our biscuits are ready, our rice will be ready in an hour, and the meatballs will be ready in an hour.
Put the meatballs
right in here, so you can bring that over.
Yeah, sure, might as well get it on camera. Just in case you drop them all, we want to capture that stuff on film.
So, that's what the meatballs look like. I'm going to turn that timer off. And try to leave the fat on there.
Very good question. She's wondering what's for dessert.
Well, you know what? Yesterday, okay, so at the, when I had the people in for dinner on Friday night, I made a great big apple crisp, but I made up my own gluten-free crust for my apple crisp. Margie, if you look in my little elm tree recipe box, there's none left, but I want to tell you about it. And they absolutely loved it, because it was for everybody. Here, thank you.
What am I looking for, Mom?
Apple crisp recipe. It should be the card. Is the card out already?
No, there's no card out.
Okay, that's funny. Anyway, it'd be under the dessert section.
You want me to hold that for you?
Oh. Here, put it on top of this. Well, anyway, I'll tell you what I think I put in it. So I put in, I think, 1.5 cups of gluten-free oats. And then I put in, I think, about 1 cup of coconut. And then I put in about 1/2 to 3/4 of 1 cup of pecans, and I put Did you find it? Okay. Yep. So, well, there I'm off there. 2 cups of gluten-free rolled oats, 1.5 cups of brown sugar, 1 cup of coconut, 2 teaspoons of cinnamon, and then I mix that all together, and then I added 3/4 cups, it says here, soft butter, but there was one person that was vegan, so I put basil. I used basil, the plant-based basil. And mix that all together, and I put half of it. My recipe for apple crisp, you spray a 9x13-inch pan with some the cooking spray, and then I sliced up probably 5 or 6 apples. Depends on how much apples. If you want more apple than anything, and then I made this gluten-free recipe, and. It wasn't the first time I made this, but I kind of made it up myself. But I put half of this in and mixed it in with all of the apples. And then the rest of it I patted over the top. So if there's anybody out there, they really liked it. And it actually tasted really, really good. But what I found was it was only good. It was good when it was just fresh. It'd be no good to have it heat up the next day because I found that the topping got... Come on in. The top kind of got hard.
Hi.
How are you?
Oh, my gosh.
We're alive. That's okay. Margie can talk to you and we'll figure out what's
happening. I just want to say I didn't think it would be you because I thought you were so big now that you'd have an agent. So I'm so surprised and happy.
Who are you?
Since the beginning.
Well, come on over here and say hello to everybody.
Oh my gosh.
We're here cooking meatballs. There we go.
Can you believe this?
Can you believe this? Only in Cape Breton.
We kept driving up the road. I said, it can't possibly be you.
It is me.
It is you. Oh, God love you.
Well, there. Now you're going to stay for a cup of tea?
I don't... Yes.
You are. Who's with you? Anybody with you?
My husband. Should I leave him in the car?
God, no. Go get him. Oh, go on.
Is he a man?
Come okay. And sit down. Right. My okay. Son is going to play the guitar in a little bit.
Oh, my gosh.
And we'll get this in the oven. Isn't that... I love this. Okay, so we're here. And now,
time for the sauce.
Time for the sauce.
It's not too hot.
No, it's not too hot.
Well, honestly, this is the highlight. I know it isn't for you.
Mary Jenna, while you're pouring this on, can I do a shout out to somebody?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So I just read this comment by a lady by the name of Jen Crampion, and she said the world needs more of this. Families cooking together. Normal everyday food, a pinch of this, a dab of that, and lots of love and laughter.
Aww.
My mom is from Knoll Shore, Nova Scotia.
Oh.
And this is down home hospitality, she would say. So, Jen, I'm from not too far from Knoll Shore. I grew up in Minasville, and I spent lots of time on the Knoll Shore with my friends that lived kind of up Knoll, East Knoll. Anyway, I wanted to say hello to you and hello to all of my... Hants County friends, and I know there are lots watching. Brennan has lots of Hants County coworkers from days gone by that tune in. So hi, Gloria. I'm sure you're watching too.
Awesome.
Oh, and my mom and dad. Hi, mom and dad.
Mom and dad.
This is turning into my show now.
I love it. It is what it is. It's just meant to be. Okay, so now we have the meatballs are all ready. Brennan, I'm going to show this a little closer.
Yeah, sure.
Here they are. Okay, and we'll get the rice. I'll put the rice in the oven.
And what did I do with that?
Rich.
I'm a daughter-in-law.
I don't usually cover them, but you can cover them if you want, and you know, maybe I will. Yes, Margie, if you grab the rice.
The cover for the pot. Not
I don't like it. It'll the cover of the pot tends to plunk down into the pot, and this heat keeps it. But, okay, we're ready to put this in the oven.
All right.
Are you ready? Don't look at my oven. My oven is soiled.
Yeah, it's been well used.
Okay, Margie. So, just like that, supper is done. Now, I have the biscuits, and I have the rice, and I have the meatballs, and we're going to throw together a little salad with that maple dressing that I made. I don't know if you tried it yet. Yeah, you have. Margie really likes it. And that recipe is also in my cookbook. So it's a cup of mayo. I like to use the Hellman's brand of mayo. And Margie, grab the cookbook there. It's standing up over on the counter. And I put it in at the last minute. They were looking for more content, so I had to put some of these things in. Let me see. If you want a really nice dressing for a salad, this is an awesome one. And we have very good friends, Mark and Elaine Pettipaw, and Mark taught with Cecil for many, many years, and now they have kind of a bit of a retirement piece of land up in Craignish, which is south of Port Hood by about 20 minutes, and but they also live in St. Andrews. But anyway, we went there for supper one night, and they had one of these salads, and everybody was just raving about how good the dressing was. So, not being a big veggie person myself, but everybody loved it so much, so she gave me her recipe, and we used it a lot for having people for supper, and so I put it in the book. So the dressing, if anybody out there who doesn't have the book, copy this down, because I think you'll love it. It's a cup of real mayo, and a quarter cup of maple syrup, a half a teaspoon of dry mustard, 2 tablespoons of white vinegar, and pepper. You know, if you love pepper. And just mix it up in a bowl, and I whisk it. And then I put it like in a mason jar and just shake it up. And I put it in the fridge so it's nice and cold by the time we go. And then I have some spinach. I want to use all that spinach up. It's not going to make a great big salad, but do you want to make it? We want to make it now, Margie? And we'll. There's cherry tomatoes, Margie. There is cucumber, and there's some of the red onion. And are you finding the spinach? You know what, it maybe went in the fridge downstairs. If not, you're gonna go to the co-op and get some. So we're gonna have this.
I can do a co-op, right?
Okay. So, hi, Leon Egan. Can you show that page in the camera? Sure. And actually, our daughter out west, she made that. Was it Tammy that made that salad, or was it Gordy for the picture?
I'm not sure. It was ready when I got there.
I think it was Tammy, our daughter Tammy in Fort McMurray. So that's the salad. So, I mean, put anything in it that you like. The suggestions are in salad one, spinach, boiled egg, red onion, mandarin oranges, bacon, and this, then mix that up. Anyway, just your own preferences, really. Salad two is a spinach, red onion, sliced strawberries, yellow pepper, walnuts. But anyway, I just, whatever I have that's available, but everybody just loves that dressing. So I think you'll like it. And we're going to make some of that. Oh, look at it.
Yeah, I found it.
Oh, you found it. Where was it?
It was in there.
They don't, do you find that? They don't know how to look in the fridge.
Did I find it?
Oh, no.
Yeah, but I did. I got there. It just wasn't in the same spot it was in the other day. The fresh dog food was in the way.
Maybe you should shred the onions next time. I'll find
it. Yeah. Okay. Okay, I forgot to say, I'm going to set the timer for 60 minutes. So we have an hour to be together, and Anna and Brennan are going to sing. And pretty soon, my brother, hopefully my brother and my sister will come, and my other brother and my sister-in-law. And we don't know, is Mitchell coming with the kids?
Who knows?
He had hockey today with two of them.
Mitchell sent these guys in his place.
Okay.
He's here taking Mitchell's place.
So, we're good. We're good. I know, it needs to jump out of the fridge at them. That's my husband, Cecil.
I found it.
Yeah, I know.
I found it, all right?
Okay. I'll be nice. I'll be nice. So, do you want them to sing a song and then we'll do the salad? Or will we just make the salad?
You're running the show, Mother.
Sometimes I wonder. Okay, I'm going to take you over to the living room and you're going to see our guests that are here. And I didn't meet her husband yet, but I will. Okay, there they are. Here they are. Hello, hello, hello. So
from Port Hope.
Port Hope. Ontario. And here you are in Port Hood. Let's see, there you go. All right. So we're going to have some music to pass the time.
Do you normally have one of the lapel mics kind of out here, or you just do it from the phone?
The lapel mics.
They don't need it. I
couldn't put it in today because I had to keep the charger in.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Good.
And because they both take this, that use the same thing. So here we have Anna, our granddaughter Anna, who named the show Tunes and Wooden Spoons, and her dad, Brennan.
What song are you going to sing?
Okay. You should say that right out loud and slowly so everybody can hear who, what song you're singing and who's it by. Go ahead, Anna.
Me?
Yeah.
This song is by Death Cab for Cutie, and it's called I'll Follow You Into the Dark.
I'm gonna turn off the kettle.
It's a loud kettle, I'll admit. That's
nice to meet you, Richard. We just can't.
five. Illuminate the nose. Vacancy signs. There's no one beside you.
Is smiling right now.
Grandma's crying over there.
Oh,
hello, everybody.
Yeah.
Good morning, company.
I definitely have it.
Come on in.
We're the
rowers
if you didn't know you had. Oh my gosh. Oh, here I am. I'm allowed to cry for my granddaughter, aren't I? Anyway. Here we have the lady that doesn't want to be on camera. It's my sister-in-law, Rita, from Romeo, Michigan. And next in line is my brother that came home from Romeo, Michigan. The oldest in our family. I'll tell him that. And this is my sister, Bernice. Bernice lives in Antigonish. And so they're coming for some meatballs and rice.
You can play the cajon if you want.
So, so how's everybody doing? And Boudreau. Oh, my gosh. I want to say this. Yesterday, it was so nice to meet people, like I told you before, who came that I seen their name so often and email me and all of that stuff. But some of you gave me some lovely and beautiful presents, and I don't ask for that from anybody, but oh my gosh, if they're all so nice. And I saw Anne Boudreaux, she was one, and thank you, Anne. And I'll be in touch with you people that did that. And thank you very, very much. So we're just going to let Brennan and carry on with Anna here. And maybe I'll even sing one with you, Brennan.
Yes, let's do that.
What'll we sing?
Do the last kiss that we were singing before.
Oh, oh my God. When I was in, I don't know what grade I was in. I was at Marble Consolidated School. If there's anybody out there, Joyce something, something, Wallace or something like that. She said hello, Bernice. She said hello. Hello. Anyway, I don't know what grade, might have been in grade 9 or maybe 10. And at that time, for Mabu, there was an enrollment of over 800, and there was very specialized grades, I guess, and made for a variety of learners that were going to Mabu school. Like, you know, there was adapted programs, and there was general program, there was family life program, there was all of that stuff. So anyway, we had people from not just around Mabu, but all around the province, really, that would come to Mabu and the and attend those programs. But anyway, I don't know where I was shy back then a little bit, and we had a school concert, and I sang. I was telling Anna today that I actually sang up on the stage at Marble Consolidated School, and I was asking her if she knew that song. So we, Margie and I and Kelly, will you guys sing too?
Yes.
Yes. This song was called Last Date.
Last Kiss. Last Kiss.
Last Kiss. Sorry. Oh, you'd think I'd know that by now. Oh, my God. And can we do that?
What key do you sing in?
Do you know? You weren't even around when we had the conversation.
You know the song, Brennan, right?
So how does it start?
I was out on a date, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah. Okay. Is there anybody there that remembers this song? Oh, we'll do this. How will we do this, Brennan?
Oh, you got it. Okay. That was on
first. I might have the wrong thing. How am I getting everybody in there? How come? There you are, Brennan. Okay.
Yeah. Do you want to come in here, Ma?
Yeah, okay.
And then.
Okay, Margie and Kelly.
So we're just in the back. We'll sway over here.
Brennan, tip that down.
We'll get seasick if you want.
The swayers are in the kitchen. I can't see anything, Brennan, with glasses.
Do you want me to make the lyrics bigger?
No, that's okay. I don't even look at the lyrics. I'm just going to remember the way I remembered them back then.
All right. Okay. I'm going with the key of G. Does that sound okay?
I have no idea. I have no idea.
Just hum the first little bit.
I can't do it. I'm scared.
Yeah, give us an intro here. Now.
Started.
I don't know how to sing it.
Well, where can my baby be? The Lord took her away.
Where can my
Margie, the reason I did that is because I thought she was going to play a little thing. She didn't know, and you didn't know, so that's my fault.
She was the only one
to
do
that. Yeah, you're the only one to do that.
So rare for you to try
and
have to do
it. Oh my god. Anyway, there now. I'll
save for another one.
Oh my god.
It's great.
What other one could we sing? Oh, sing it.
You would cry too if it happened to you.
When you know where my money is. Something.
Almost the same song. Are we actually doing that?
Yeah. Sure.
Oh, why
do
not?
Do it. The words well enough, Margie. What about that one, you know, Grandpa, this one we used to sing all the time.
The
Yeah!
Oh, that's a nice
one. Remember that one?
Yeah.
See if you can remember the words of that. There's some high notes in there.
I was only 17, is that what I was that, or that later in the song?
That's later in the song, I think.
A Nitty Gritty Dirt Band?
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. You got it?
Way
well,
to go,
I
Anna.
Have something.
Oh, yes, yes. For as long as I remember.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Forgive me. Try it. And you get those high notes, Brennan.
No problem.
I don't know if
because
that's right.
Because my voice is so high.
I don't know if that's the right key for me, Anna.
Yeah.
I think that's, is that?
Can you get up there?
You can't see.
Voice cracks.
Yeah, not very pleasantly.
Well, let's do it anyway. We're okay, at home, so... and there's visitors in, and nobody else is watching.
That's only 700 people. What key?
G?
Or G?
G.
Yeah, that's good. That's it. Yeah. I love this song. God, we haven't sang that in a long time.
Sure.
Ready?
This is that's in the key of C. If
someone else
can
this one, right? Yeah. Because we always used to sing this one.
That's right.
For as long as I remember, when Friday nights came around, the family would gather down at Grandma's house. The supper over and the dishes done, and then the best time came. He said it was his style. Grandma called him ornery, but she said it with a smile. Even he could not disguise the love he felt so strong. All could see it in his eyes when she'd play his favorite song. She'd play Beautiful Dreamer, My Wild Irish Rose. She never played it perfect, but there was love in every note. Grandpa sat beside her, in harmony they sang. At the old upright piano that only Grandma played.
I think it's time for you.
For me what?
To sing.
I've been singing. With you.
No, but I need to get out of here. Thank you.
Blocked you in intentionally. Who's next? Brita, are you up now?
Well, yeah, it's Bree's turn.
Kelly?
I think we should get Bernice to do the
Tunes of Little Spoon
Spook.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Is that right? I'm not sure if I know all the right chords.
Yeah.
version of that one.
A little jazz thrown into it.
Yeah. I like it. I think I better do it and see. This, for some reason, this song, growing up, this was the, this when Terry Kelly put out that album, I forget what it's called now, is it this Evangeline album? Anyway, this song I played on AM radio, like, all the time, so it was something you always heard, so you just learned it just because it was on all the time, and then once in a blue moon, at a party, see, remember that Terry Kelly song? And we would pull it out once in a while, so let's try it. It's funny how some songs, you hear the little bit of a melody and just boom, comes back to you, like every lyric. And try it, you gonna play along or?
I'm gonna attempt to, if I...
I might not play it right, but I think it's close.
If I piece out halfway through, that's
tiny little stars dance around in front of her eyes. He cried on her shoulder and sat there and told her sad stories and little white lies. And if not for that one indiscretion, it would have been an uneventful day. If not for that single obsession, things would never have gone. She had one last drink and she didn't think twice. In fact, she didn't think at all. My, my, how far can a little girl fall? He walked out of the bar, she climbed into his car, and they drove to somewhere deep in the night. He slipped off her ring and the rest of it. The slightest alarm, forget everything her mama once said. For once or a moment, in the back of her mind, a tiny picture came and lifted her head. Well, she remembered a man who was waiting at home, and a baby barely learning to crawl. Fans out there.
Specifically Metallica.
Well, yeah, maybe heavy metal, somewhat, yeah, but any Metallica fans in the Tunes and Wooden Spoons crowd?
Crickets.
crickets. All the Metallica fans are not showing up.
Where are you?
But Metallica, if you know who they are, pretty heavy, very famous kind of heavy rock band from the 80s, 90s, and to this day. But they put out, a number of artists put out a cover album covering Metallica songs. Metallica Blacklist is that what it's called. And I don't know if you know who Phoebe Bridgers is.
I'm going to guess not many people will.
But she's a very interesting artist, and she did a cover of Nothing Else Matters, which was one of their big hits back in the early 90s, and I love it. It's very interesting.
And it's not heavy metal, because I can't do that.
You look like a headbanger, you know? Anyway, give it a go.
My hair. Can't mess it up.
Thank you. It's not a dark song at all.
Golden ring, pretty.
Oh, that's a good one. That's a good one.
Yeah.
You're gonna have to sing the girl part though.
Oh my god, I don't know if I can remember the words, but let me sit in there.
Shop in Chicago on a sunny summer day. A couple gazes at the wedding rings there on display.
Smiles and falls her head. He says, honey, that's for you. It's not much, but it's the best that I can do.
Golden ring with one shining. For someone to take it home by itself. It's just a cold metallic ring. Only love can make a golden wedding ring. In a little wedding chapel, later on that afternoon, an old rock.
Whispers, Lord, with this ring I will wed.
Golden ring, golden ring, with one tiny little soul, shining ring. Now at last it's found a home by itself. It's just a gold metallic thing. Only love. In a small two-room apartment, as they fought their final round, people said you won't admit it, but I know you're leaving town.
He said one thing's for certain, I don't love you anymore. And throws down the ring, she walks out.
Like the love that's dead and gone by itself. It's just a cold metallic thing. Only love can make a golden wedding ring. In a pawn shop in Chicago on a sunny summer day, a couple gazes at the wedding rings there on display. Golden rings.
Well, folks,
whoo,
it's that time. Supper's ready.
It's ready, all right.
Ready?
You're gonna show people your
product? We're gonna show them the finished product.
Okay. Oh, it's over here.
So, Brennan, do you wanna grab
the meatball?
The meatballs and take them over to the table and we'll show them to everybody. Great to have help. Your family loves to sing that song, Shirley. That's great. There we are.
Stir it up.
Yep, just stir it up so that it's everything's covered and saucy.
Gotta have the sauce.
The biggest meatballs. Stir in the meatballs.
I just got that, Marie. It's a little slow. On the slow side.
Thanks, everybody.
Okay. And now I would ask you to put the meatballs over on that other place.
I can do that.
And we'll stir the rice. When it comes out, usually you'll see all the mushrooms laying on the top. And we're going to get a nice spoon here. Okay, Margie, go ahead. Just stir it all up.
Pressure. Oh, my goodness.
There we go.
Did I feel it? I would
be this nervous stirring rice. You know, when I had to go live yesterday to tell you all that we were going to do the book launch, and I was like, oh, this is going to be fine. I have never been that nervous in my life. I was like, how does my mother do this every week? And we used to, like, make, you know, not make fun of her, but like, Mom, you got to watch your camera work and whatever. And it's like, no.
It's hard.
Like, I have a new appreciation after yesterday, for sure.
Guess we're having leftovers off the chocolate cake and leftovers from all the goodies that Sharon Nicholson McCachran made yesterday for the launch. She had made lots of lovely squares and things. So there's lots of goodies here to have. So I wasn't going to make anything else for dessert. And of course, panda biscuits. And Margie found the carrots. And so here you go. There we go.
Are all these things in the book?
Yes, they are all in the recipe book. So I want to say our lovely drop-in guests from Port Hope.
It just came in to get two cookbooks.
I realized
you're
getting into
it. Exactly.
And they had a little cup of tea. They wouldn't have anything with it, but I'm going to get them their cookbooks and sign it for them, and very shortly we'll be sitting down, and we're not having tea right now. We are going to enjoy our supper, and then we'll have tea after supper. So I just want to say thank you all for joining in. Next week, we're having a very special guest. If you're into the Gaelic scene, we're having Mary Jane Lamond here next Sunday. Mary Jane has to eat gluten-free, so we'll be having a gluten-free recipe from her. I'm not sure just what it will be yet. We're going to decide on that this week, but she'll also be singing some beautiful Gaelic songs, so I'm really looking forward to that. Again, thank you all for tuning in yesterday and again today. And I know that you know that you matter to me and that I want you to love one another, and I love you. Bye-bye, everybody. Have a wonderful week.
Hey, hi, it's me, Charlie. If you like Grandma's video, make sure to give it a like and subscribe.